Hi, friends, and welcome to our latest edition of Keeping Up with the Jackrabbits. I'm Tyler Merriam. So great to have you with us here in the middle of July, and we are joined by a member of the strength and conditioning staff here at South Dakota State, Andre McIntyre. And Andre, welcome to the show. Hope you're doing well.
Oh, yeah, things are well. Thanks for having me on.
Well, thank you for joining us. I want to tell your story a little bit just to begin for those who don't know. You were a college athlete. Tell us about that.
Oh, yeah. Well, I played football at Wayne State College, kind of right down the street, not too far, northeast Nebraska. Played there for a little bit, 5 years or so, and was afforded an opportunity. So did that and got my degree and kind of moved on from there, went back to Nebraska. Worked as a physical therapy tech for a while, and which is okay, but kind of changed my niche. Kind of went into more of the personal training, physical fitness route, and got into that, and was interning and had an opportunity to go to Creighton. Interned there for a while. Did some stuff in Lincoln as well as a personal trainer on the private sector side, and my connection at Creighton. Kind of got me up here, you know, and had an opportunity to interview with Coach Mo a few times, and it was an opportunity to come here as a GA, and been here ever since, going on my, I think, second year. Yeah, getting ready to start my second year as a full-time assistant. So 4 years in now, it's kind of been fast. It's worth it. It's been a whirlwind, but I cannot complain, I'll tell you that.
You talked about it a little bit, but you didn't go into strength and conditioning at a college athletics level right away, but you got into it when you were at Creighton. Walk me through what led you back into college athletics.
For me, it was a kind of a slow process. I mean, it was time. Like I said, I was working as a physical therapy tech for a while, and I just didn't feel that spunk that you kind of feel when you kind of go into work, and I sometimes dreaded it. And I knew it was kind of my time to just move on. I knew I loved to be around sports. When a young athlete would come in, I got kind of spunked up, and that's the one I wanted to work with. So I knew I needed to be around that. And for me, being around sports has always been a driving factor in my life. So to get back to that, I needed that. Like I said, I couldn't ask for anything different. I love what I do, to kind of see those kids' smiles and to accomplish some things that they haven't never accomplished or didn't see in themselves. I think it's all worthwhile for sure.
For those who do not know, take me through all the different sports that you've worked with, because it's been a number of them during your time here at South Dakota State.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I think I've probably worked with most of them, to be honest. As a GA, I kind of got some of the other sports, the lower sports, which was great. I mean, that opportunity to work with any athlete for me is amazing, but to be in a different realm and different, some unknowns that I've never been around. Equestrian was one. I've never really been around horses at all. But it was great though. You know what I mean, and they love what they did, and for them to have passion, it made me want to be able to do my job better. For them, you know what I mean, and this is what they're here. And I was in their shoes, like I said, being a college athlete, so I understand. But yeah, I've worked with, I think, almost all of them. Right now I'm over, I primarily work with, football, women's soccer, wrestling, and the sprints and jumps, both men and women. So, those are my main teams as of right now, but over the 4 years I've worked with, pretty much, every athlete that's probably walked through here for.
Those that are aware of athletics might know who your dad is. He has quite a story, doesn't he?
Yeah, I guess so. For him, he actually is the trainer of a prize fry fighter, Bud Crawford. So my dad's Brian McIntyre. They call him Bro Mac, from Omaha, but. Bud Crawford, a good friend of mine, we've been knowing him for a long time, and my dad is his trainer and manager or co-manager. So small world. Yeah, without a doubt. I tell you that.
Have you gotten in the ring with him?
No, it's not my niche. I'm more of a team sport athlete. Let's just keep it that.
if I may compliment you on your intelligence, Andre, I will right now for avoiding that, but
yeah, I'm, back out. Let me stay over here.
The past couple of months have obviously overseen a tremendous amount of change, not only in our culture, but also with athletics throughout the different colleges. And every college is handling it a little bit differently, but with Black Lives Matter and how the support of the community of Brookings and other communities here in this region and really throughout the nation has been something to see. As a Black man living here in Brookings, South Dakota, what have the past couple of months been like as you've watched all this play out?
To be honest, it was difficult to say the least to start, because you didn't, like you said, being a Black man in South. I mean, I think it all says it for itself. It's kind of a rarity. You are secluded sometimes. I am from a big city, a bigger city, I should say, where the diversity is vast. So it was difficult to say the least to start. But as things started moving, as time goes on, you start to. People start reaching out, which was great, because you really start to understand that people care. I think the biggest thing that most people were saying, and especially Black people, African American people, is just listening, and to have people do that and to genuinely listen, not just to do it just because it was the right thing to do. And you can tell the difference. There's no question about it. But to genuinely listen and to understand the pain, the anger, the frustration, everything that I was feeling, and I could be able to just kind of lay it on them, it's been a relief. I can tell you that. So as these months have gone on, I feel encouraged for sure. We got some things going on within our athletic department, the minority coaches and staff members, support staff that we have. Along with our AD, Justin, and Miss Halens and Alex Wood, we got a lot of things going on that I'm very, very encouraged about. Looking into to voter initiative stuff, and John Johnson is heading that up. We're looking into just relationships with the UPD and BPD, and then Coach Christian Smith of football is heading that up. Then we're also, we're also trying to involve ourselves within just the overall community of Brookings and the campus of Brookings, right? And I think it needs to be inclusive, right? We can't exclude each other from anything, and to have a broad understanding of that, of the diversity that everybody needs. It's encouraging for sure. People are putting their bootstraps on and taking it one step at a time, but actually taking action versus just speaking on it. So
there were a couple of student athletes who relayed to a coach I talked to, who said, you know, it's not like we felt threatened previously in Brookings, but watching this play out and then the protest, if you want to call it that, or the event that occurred here in Brookings with Black Lives Matter a few weeks ago, said that was the first time I really felt that people were truly behind me. Not that they just appreciated me as a student athlete, but that they truly were backing me as a person.
Well, yeah, I 100% agree with that. And I'm not even a student. I mean, just as a Black man, as a proud Black man, I 100% agree with that. That was one of the first times that I felt appreciated, and people were actually behind me. And like I said, that starts to happen. That ball started rolling. And as time goes on, you start feeling that. But I 100% agree with that statement, with that whoever that said that, for sure.
And with that, I think that's such an important part of this, is we can talk about these committees, we can talk about some of the things that coaches and administrators are trying to do, but in the end, it's about those student-athletes, and I know that you have relationships with those individuals and no doubt have played a mentoring role through some of this, because, again, they're looking for an outlet.
Yeah, there's no question. I mean, I know we keep saying student-athlete, but it really is just the individual. I mean, to be real honest, I mean, you want to have genuine connection and understanding of an individual. I think we've talked about it already. Communication has happened. But to have a genuine connection, you have to actually listen and intently listen and want to do it, not just do it because it's the right thing to do at this point in time. Right. We want to get past this, to be better as people, not as just student athletes, not as me, as just being Andre, but as people, as a whole. You have to intently listen and drive connection between people. My mentoring that I try to do with them, it is about them. It is their time, but it isn't just a student athlete, right? Eventually, you're going to be done being a student athlete, yeah, and you'll be a person like I am, right? Trying to help somebody be better. So that's what I'm trying to do right now, because somebody did it to me, right? So I'm just paying it forward.
No, that's a great point. That, again, it's about being a person more than a student athlete. That is a terrific point, Andre. And I think that's the other element in this, too, is it's one thing to come out and make a public statement, which many people have. But that was one area where Justin was adamant, is that this is something that we need to really have an infrastructure for, and to allow a platform for Kiki Stokes, who's been so involved in the softball side of it and some of the things. And you've mentioned some of the other names of John and Christian and Alex, who isn't a coach, but who has a wife who's a coach in the department and works on campus. There's so many different voices, and I get the sense, without being in those committees, that he has basically said, okay, you tell me what we need to do. Not, well, we need to do this, but you tell me, what can we do? And then you guys have tried to figure things out from there.
Yeah, there's no question. I'm from the beginning, he has reached out and just said, tell me what can we do? And we've leaned on him, right? There's no question. You mean a person like Justin, you lean on him because of his expertise and how he handles situations. But he literally just sits back and takes notes. It's usually us taking notes, right? Usually, to be honest, right? But he's sitting back taking notes and putting this together for us. And we're having a genuine conversation and being able to lay out expectations and plans and feelings, though, right? And it can genuinely flow versus you kind of already have a route of this conversation, how it's going to go, or you have an angle on it, right? And that's not how Justin is right now, and I appreciate that. Like, that's the most important thing. Like I said, when your leader is genuine about what he's talking about, right, he's saying that he wants to do this stuff instead of we need to, and then he's reiterating that within our staff meetings and our coaches meetings, right, and then you're seeing this trickling down from the top on in, and that's the infrastructure that he's talking about, in my opinion, right? That's what we're talking about. And then you got the others ones that, like I said, our subcommittees, the John Johnson's doing, taking care of the voting initiative, the Christians taking care of like our relationship with UPD, and then Alex Wood with the departmental programming and our relationship with academia and athletics and community. Like, he's allowing people to do what they want to do, and we're getting it done. And that's the good thing about it, is when you allow people to flourish, right, you don't know what can happen. But if you hold back, you can't allow them to just grow and mature and bring forth the stuff that they have. So it's been amazing. I can't ask for a better leader right now, to be honest.
Andre, I would assume many of our listeners are like me, somebody who grew up here in South Dakota, who has lived his entire life in South Dakota. And while certainly I have had a ton of interaction here over the past 15 plus years being at South Dakota State with black individuals and other minorities, particularly with the athletic department, of course, with coaches and staff members and student athletes, we all, I'm sure, tend to think, well, we don't do anything that would be considered racist, or we don't do anything that would cause any issues. But there obviously can be subtleties or things that are looked at. As someone who wants to do right, and I'm sure there's so many out there like me who are listening, what can we do to help? What can we do to further the cause? Is there something we should know? I'm putting you on the spot there, kind of an awkward question, I know, but
no,
I'm just...
No, that's an amazing question, because I think about it myself. And I don't think about it, I honestly, and this is, like I said, this is personal opinion, but I don't think it all falls on everybody else. I think it involves us too. Everybody has to educate themselves, right? You have to be able to educate each other and empower each other, right? You need to be a part of the solution as well, right? Don't be a part of the, or not a part of the solution, right? Everybody needs to be included in this. And like I said, I've been kind of hitting on it this whole time. For me, it's not just about the communication piece of it. Like I said, this has to be a genuine understanding of people, all right, and where they come from and wanting to do it, right? And that's what drives connection, right? That's when we can tell, like, okay, yeah, he is actually a good person, right? And then you actually start caring about them and then what's going on in their lives versus just the how are you doing? That's scratching the surface, right? That's not depth. Right. If you're trying to grow, we have to grow depth. And that's in educating each other and empowering each other to understand and be a part of the solution moving forward. Good question. Hard question for sure. And I don't know if I answered it completely, but I think education is probably it's a very big piece.
Well, the fact that I think you and I both feel more comfortable having this conversation now than maybe we were a few months ago. And it's unfortunate the things that had to occur for us to get to this point, maybe.
Yeah, yeah,
but
yeah.
The fact that we are here, hopefully, is a sign that we are moving in the right direction, even though it is later than it should be, that hopefully we're all taking a step in the route that we should.
No, I wholeheartedly agree with that. Like I said, just to have the conversation, just to have the comfortability, if that's a word, to be able to have this conversation. Like I said, you just said, and I don't know how easy this is 4 months ago, 6 months ago, even a year ago, right? But now that it's time, if that's a word, it's yeah. time to make this happen, right? It's time to move forward. And we will do it together. I think Justin keeps saying this, we will, yeah, we're going to do this together. There's no question about it. There is no one side or the other side. Like I told you earlier, we educate each other and we empower each other. Yeah, first it starts with the individual. But if every individual is doing that, then we can grow forward.
And there are so many examples, and Andre, you certainly have seen them. I've been privy to them of people who, student athletes who come here, again, from all walks of life and all different colors, shapes, sizes, who come here and who benefit from the education and who have a great learning experience and are better people at the finish line than they were at the starting line. And if things like this can help everybody become a better person in the end, then that's what it's all about.
Yeah, there's no question. Isn't that the goal, right?
Absolutely.
Right? And better, then betterment and empowerment of people, right? Better at the end than where you started. So, no, I wholeheartedly agree with that for sure.
Well, neighbor, it's fun to watch you ride your bike around here at a much brisker pace than I ever could periodically. So I look forward to seeing you again. And thank you again so much for this conversation. It was very enlightening for myself. I hope it was for the crew. And excited to see what all these committees can come up with and what myself and what others can do to assist in all of those endeavors.
Yeah, well, I appreciate you having me on. Like I said, I'm excited about this stuff that we have in the works. I mean, with everything going on, who knows what'll happen. But just to be able to talk about this and to actually put this on paper and have ideas flowing back in and people that want to do better and be better, it's just amazing. So I appreciate you to having me on. And hopefully I was able to educate some people and help some people out with some questions. So if anybody needs anything, know where to reach out to me for sure.
Absolutely. Andre McIntyre, thank you for your time. And we will chat in the very near future, hopefully in person, and we'll get back to some normality here sooner than later.
That'd be great. That'd be great. Thanks for having me on. Have a good night.
Thanks, Andre. I'm Tyler Merriam. We'll see you next time on Keeping Up with the Jackrabbits.